Welcome to Office 2013 video number 21, Excel Basics video number 3. Hey, in this video, we want to talk about counting and adding. Now, I've already downloaded the workbook. If we go over to our web page, Video Class Project 21, there's the workbook you want to download. And if you were in class yesterday, I've changed the workbook. So if you're watching this video over the weekend, you got to re-download the video. Hey, we need to learn how to count and add. Now, many of us know how to count and add, but in this video, we want to see how to either add numbers or count items. Not only all the items in the column, but sometimes we want just some of them. So if I wanted to count how many sales rep GG there were, I do not want all of the records or the whole column. I just need to count 4. If I was adding all of the sales for GG, I don't want to use the sum function and add the whole column. I want to add just the ones that belong to GG. So in this video, we're going to see how to count, add, and then count and add with a criteria or condition. All right, let's talk about the count function first. Count, C-O-U-N-T, and as we've seen in this class, there's some cool drop-downs for functions, and there's a little screen tip that tells you what the function does. Count counts numbers. So I can simply highlight. If you highlight a bunch of text, it just gives you 0 because it's not programmed to count anything except for numbers. So count counts numbers. And there's 9 records here. Now sometimes you have a column of names or other type of data that's not a number. So you can't use the count function. In that case, we can use COUNTA. Now COUNTA, if you read this screen tip, it counts cells that are not empty. That means COUNTA will count anything, whether it's a number or word or error or anything. However, for words, this is a great function to use. I'm going to highlight. So in this case, of course, we could use COUNT here. But sometimes you're not given numbers. You're given text, name, something like that, and you want to count. So the COUNTA, we'll look through all of these words and count 9 of them. Now, to counting, right? We counted numbers. We counted text items with the COUNTA function. Adding, well, we know the SUM function. And similar to COUNT, if you were to try and add a bunch of words, it just says, hey, there's 0, right? So that's not going to work. However, if you put into the number argument numbers, it will add them. And it will add all of them. So the total for this column is 2,400. Now we want to talk about adding and counting with a condition or a criteria. Let's first talk about the COUNTIFS. Now they named this function nicely, right? Count. Well, I don't want to count all the items. I want to count the items if they're equal to GG. Now there's S just means you can do one or more conditions or criteria. So right now, we want to see how to use the COUNTIFS function to count not all the records, but just the ones that belong to GG. So COUNTIFS. Now there's a COUNTIF, that's an earlier function. But the ones with the S since 2007, and that's a long time ago, are a little bit more polite and easier to use. So we're going to use the ones with the S, even if we have just a single condition. Now the nice thing about the screen tips is it tells you criteria range, and then please give me the criteria. All right, so criteria range. Well, this is just like the COUNTA. We just highlight all of them. All right? Well, right now, COUNTIFS wouldn't know what to do because, comma, you have to tell it which ones. Remember, counting, not all the items, just some of them. In order for COUNTIFS to know which one of those to count, you have to give it criteria. So we're going to click on GG. And now it'll do its thing. It will look through that whole column. It'll say, is that equal to GG? False. Is that equal to GG? True. And it will continue down counting 4. Now later in this class, we'll come back and we'll see how to add more arguments. You can have lots of criteria here. It will count 4. Now, what if someone told you, well, you have a bunch of dates here, and I just want to count how many transactions were on 1023? Well, if we used count and counted all of them, dates or numbers, right, it would give me all of them, but that's not what I want. I want to use count, and there's a bunch of cool functions. Count, counts number, counta, counts not empty cells, count blank. You mean sometimes you want to count empty cells? Yeah, sometimes you want to count empty cells. Ah, but count ifs. I'm going to double click that one. Hey, criteria range. Remember, if we were using count or counta for this matter, because none of these cells are empty, we would enter into the range, broop, all of them. But we don't want to count all of them. So what do? We use count ifs, enter the range, comma, and tell it what the condition or the criteria is. So I click on that date. It will instantly go through. Are you equal to 1023? True. Are you equal to 1023? True. Are you equal to 1023? False. It will go all the way through and count exactly how many dates are 1023. Exactly 4. Now, we can come up here. Let's delete this GG and type 10/23/2013. And so we can see 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 4 of them. So in both of these cases, we use count ifs to not count all of them, but just some of them. Now, let's talk about adding. Well, we could do the same thing. If we wanted to add all of GG's, if I come up here, delete this, and type GG, I could do it manually, right? I could say 200, and watch this. I'm going to use my control trick to select cells not next to each other. Click and drag. Now here's a great trick. You can actually, in Excel, the status bar, we saw in Word the status bar showed like the page number. But look at this. If you highlight numbers in Excel or cells, it will show you calculation results. The status bar is programmed to show you sum, basic calculation. So what's the total right there? The sum is 1,100, right? So how did it do that? Well, we didn't add up all of the numbers, just some of them. Now here's the trick, because we're going to do the sum ifs formula here. Well, we're of course are going to have to give sum ifs the whole column of numbers. But we're also inside the sum ifs function going to have to give it the whole column of names, and then tell sum ifs only get the GG ones. All right, so you ready? Equals sum if, and sum if is an earlier function. It's existed for a long time, but it only does one condition. Sum ifs does one or more. And the reason we use the sum ifs is because it's a little bit easier to use. So even if you're using one condition, use sum ifs. And the reason why is the screen tip, the names of the arguments, are much easier to understand. When it says sum range, remember sum means adding. So whenever you see sum range, hey, those are the numbers. So I'm going to highlight all the numbers. Now, comma. Criteria range. Well, we need to add only GG's. Oh, well then the sum ifs in the criteria range one argument needs to look at all of the names. Now notice these are both the same size, comma, and then the criteria. Well, somehow sum ifs needs to look through here and know which ones. So sum ifs in the criteria one, we give it the condition or the criteria. Okay, close parentheses. Control Enter. And sure enough, it went through and got only GG's sales numbers and then added them. How did SUMIFS do it? It actually took this criteria GG and went through each name in the sales rep column and asked, are you equal to GG? False. So it didn't do anything with that number. Are you equal to GG? True. So it took that number and remembered it. Are you equal to GG? False. So it didn't do anything with that number. Every time it did not find a match, it didn't use the number. But when it found a match, in this case 1, 2, 3, it took each one of these numbers. So it used this column to match criteria, but it took the number from this column and added them. Hey, let's look at another adding with a condition example. Now, we want to add the numbers from this column, but only when we find a date in the date column that matches 10/23/2013. Now, let's go ahead and change this up here. So we get a visual there. It'll help us while we're learning. All right, so I'm going to come over to G13 and use the SUMIFS equals SUMIFS. Now, we have some arguments here in our screen tip that we have to enter. Sum range. Hey, that just means those are the numbers we want to add. Broop. Comma. Criteria range. Well, I don't want to add all of them, so I want to add just the ones that fall on 10/23, so I have to tell SUMIFS. Hey, the criteria range, well, that's all the dates. Same size, comma. And since we don't want to add all of them, we've got to tell SUMIFS what the criteria is. Hey, it's 10/23. Close parentheses. Control Enter. $600. And I can even add this up. There's three, and there's three right there. How did it do it? Again, SUMIFS had to take this criteria and find matches in this column. Anytime it found a match, it took the number from this column. Anytime it did not find a match, it didn't use the number. So it didn't add all of them, just the ones on 10/23. That is pretty amazing. SUMIFS to add with one condition. Hey, in this video, we saw how to count and add. We saw how to use the COUNT function if we wanted to count all the numbers. COUNTA if we wanted to count all the text items in a column. And the SUM function to add all of the numbers in a column. But we don't always want to count or add all of the items. Sometimes we want to add or count just some of them. So we learned about the COUNTIFS function. That allows you to count with one or more condition or criteria. COUNTIFS, it was great for counting just GG in this column. We also saw how to add, not all of them, but just some of the numbers using SUMIFS. That's when you want to add with one or more condition or criteria. We saw how to use SUMIFS to add from the sales column all of GG sales. All right, we'll see you next video.